with the project squad. This is Heavy. Now today I'm going to give an update on the Kevin Epstein situation. The preliminary autopsy is done now. You can now hear the official cause of death. I'm also going to touch on the facts there. In Jamaica, and well, I guess it's the world, to be honest, based on how information move fast. You know, back in the day, people said 9-day story. Right, they even cut it down to 3-day story. This case is a perfect example, right, of how people consume information and how people store information, right, completely change thanks to the internet. I'm also going to briefly touch on the Klansman trial, because as expected, the defense lawyer, right, is now tackling C4, and I bring the argument that I expected them to bring, to be honest. Now, we can start off with Kevin Epstein. The official autopsy come out, and by the way, it was observed by independent pathologists, it was observed by Indicom, it was observed by the government. So, right, that means, you know, because people might say, well, all we know is another governmental lie. All we know is, well, let me say, independent people did it, right, Indicom did it. I want to hear something spooky going on, so I'm just going to read MSC and I'm check it out by nationwide. Blunt force trauma. And by the way, remember I said a constable also lost his life. That's Orlando Irons. Right? So the two of them, right, they must have blunt force trauma. Based on how the vehicle them look, right, it's not hard to imagine, right? So that would have been the official cause of death. As you can imagine, vehicles are traveling at a certain speed, then come to a sudden stop, right, or somebody comes slam into it, right, and then all of a sudden, the human body that you think is big and tough and strong, right, is met with all these kinetic forces, and even though the outside look like say, everything good, the insides they mash up, especially when depending on which part the car get licked, or it's not a type of car or design, with all, I think them call them crumple zone now, because remember one time people they believe say, the best way to survive car crash is to build some big old tough car when a bend down a fall. Right? But we now know so that's not true. Right? Engineers now start for a design car, right, for crumple. Because you want that vehicle to absorb some of the kinetic energy, right, and the wall light not go through your body because you're going to be in for a very, very bad day. So, them say blunt force trauma. Right? Nobody no come out come say, in family them no come out come say, right, them feel like a spooky thing, I go and lie them and tell. So, as me say, we are work, we oversee us, but that don't make it any less spooky. There's still so many questions surrounding all of this. But, 9-day story, them days are done. 3-day story now, 5-day story the most. We're now living in a time when there's simply so much information that something like that can happen, and a week later people are saying, oh yeah. I mean the man from the mobile, yeah. People almost forget already. That show you how much information people get overload. People can't even keep up. It's like within 3-4 days there's a newer, bigger topic and the old one get pushed aside. You know who that's great for? The people them were happy say Kevin Smith gone and he can't talk. Them know the masses are easily distracted by entertainment and gimmicks. It not gonna last long. Some celebrity story will come out with who they want to breed for or something like so and completely take out people their mind off everything. May I give another example? The Davian Bryan story from St. Thomas. When was the last time anybody talked about that? Remember how it was the biggest thing in Jamaica? Catching Davian Bryan was the biggest thing. Man all farm them own team, go in the bush, go look for man, take all the wrong man life. That come like 15 years ago. I'm not even here if they catch him or not. I don't know. Somebody can probably update me at the comment section. Comment section, not my DM. But from when I seen the news, I didn't hear nothing but I catch Davian Bryan. And that was the biggest story, right, in Jamaica at one point. Nothing lost for a long period of time. The concentration of the public, people can't keep up. Too much things are going on, too much information. So it shows the society and the world get flipped upside down. One time there was no information. One time if you want to see something you have to read, every country might have one or two big papers and you have to just read this, or you have to just watch the 2 channel in your country or listen to the few little radio station. No, right? Because you get a new story every 15 minutes. Right? The story that come out 2 days ago, feel like 2 years. Living in crazy times. even some of my videos them. There are videos I'm gonna drop, and sometimes YouTube recommend but my own video them to me. I'm gonna see the video, I'm like, that was only 5 months ago? That feel like 5 years. It feel like me live on YouTube for 5 years. Sometimes I feel like the whole world isn't again jutsu and we just completely lost all sense of space and time. Me don't know where I'm going. Anyway, let me touch on the Klansman trial. As expected, the lawyer said, right, the C4, right, only testified because he didn't want to save himself. But because C4 was never arrested, his name never even depend on case document or nothing, the lawyer said, well, C4 preempt what will happen. That's why. Here's the problem with that argument. People who cooperate with the security forces to the extent to where C4 go are people we already realize that they're done for. In other words, people like Ratos. Them done for. Not preemptive, not more. A one night the man go call my name. Me go take it upon myself and go to these extreme limits. Remember, him never just go to the police and say me know something and then him gone and then turn up. Right? Pan trial day. We know what you say. C4 carried on working with the police, working with CTAC while still being in the gang. At his own discretion. If I preempt, you know, cause like the lawyer say, true you say you wonder if you never go to jail, that's why you go to the next day. Alright, maybe if you testify. But to then carry out covert operations, even carrying CTAC members in a Klansman place, right? Taking cell phone, having conversations, recording conversations, and then carrying it back with CTAC, them level of extent there. Right. It's not what the man do when them feel like there is a chance them name might get called. That is what would happen when you realize you don't get sink already and you're back against the wall and there's no way left to turn. But for you go volunteer when the witness them when they have before were not capable of sinking clans. We know that for a fact now. You know how we know so the witness them when they have before. If they did have any, were not capable of sinking clans without C4, CTAC would have sink C4 too. Let me repeat, if the case was so solid, right, as the defense lawyer, I try make the argument that, you know, the man, everybody will get sink and C4 want to save himself, so him go before him get. If the witness would have, if they did have known, was so solid, then C4 would have been redundant. The same reason why now, nobody with the pan trial can hold their hand and say, no, say more want on state witness because they're not needed anymore. It's like you try to understand Barcelona football tactics, Pep Guardiola tactics with Messi them, right? And you meet somebody, you meet the man where supply water to the team, right? And him tell you, say, you know, say, me can give you a couple of information because one and two time walk past and hear some things. And you say, alright, we're gonna work with you, tell what you know. Right. If that waterman information was so solid and him could have figured out and give you Pep Guardiola's tactics, inside secrets, right, then guess what? Then you can bring down Barcelona. And if a player from the team try to approach you and tell you about the tactics, then you're gonna say, you know what, we don't have everyone and we can bring down Barca now. But if you don't have everything and you're not confident, say you can stop Barca, and then Iniesta link you and say, no, sir, we can give you some inside secrets. Then, when you work with Iniesta, you know, sir, realize, hold on, you know, sir, we have everything we need. We don't need nobody else to come tell you nothing. We don't need Javi, we don't need Messi, we don't need nobody else to come bring down Barca. If the police them did have a witness that could sink Klansman without C4, they would not work with C4. C4 would be on trial too. And they definitely wouldn't be risking no officers going in a Klansman place and I go through this and I go through that. If they did have a witness that were capable of giving equal or greater intel. The first witness wasn't good, but the real bombshell them are coming from C4. Because him higher up in the system and have more intel. I mean, I talk about somebody where it bamboozle even the system. As far as most people were concerned, in a Klans, C4 was behind bars. They might look for see him. Right. Pan the trial, went down the area, said, he might witness them things there. But because he was behind bars, and then if he come out and get a lesser sentence, him work with the police and I got us testify. Them never know, say, C4 was never behind the bars. And him that work with C-Talk this whole time. A complete different case from Matos Kratos, who was arrested and convicted for murder and arson, and then get a lesser sentence. So, may expect the defense lawyer to bring this argument, but it now go wall up. C4 is the one of the intel can sink clans. If police never need him, they may say, well, thank you for the information, now go on a jail. Right, go over there, so, right, go wall your bunk, a jail house too. People in the courtroom can tell the expression on the clansman them face when they realize that C4 was working with C-Talk all along. Even certain shootings and upsetting go on, right? Certain way how police would get certain guns and 87s did dead and certain man did live. At them time it makes sense to them. Pan trial. So I expect this defense. It's the defense in every trial when a member of the gang, right, start testify against him own gang. Defense lawyer go say, you just try to save yourself. But you have the first show say, them wall on, pan the man, charge him, he might face big time, and then, cause he might try to save himself, he decide say, he might go just talk. We are talking about somebody where the police them never even know about. Somebody where the police them think was a troll. Police thinks a troll, them a troll in time, the man approach and tell him say, right, he is a member of clans and can give him information. That means that the police them never even know about C4. So all them are going to sink him. Or them are going to put him back against the wall for force him to talk. Them run with the man as a troll. The argument now go stand up. Anyway, we can see how it play out. I feel like there's still more twists and turns left in this trial. So Patreon squad, big up on yourself. DIA, you don't know, more life. Ultra squad, stay circling. Bless.